We are back at the Mac Sports Complex on the campus of Hofstra University for the last game of our trifecta of Catholic High School Athletic Association Girls Basketball Championship play today. We have crowned two champions earlier today. Sacred Heart Academy from Buffalo went home with our Class B title. And we just crowned our Class A champion, the Vikings from St. Joseph's by the Sea. We now await our double A champion. Will it be Monsignor Scanlon or will it be St. Mary's? We are 1 minute and 10 seconds away from the start of our last and final championship game. Before we get into starting lineups, we'll have the playing of the national anthem as both teams are getting ready for their final pregame chat. We are 45 seconds away from our start. The Gales from St. Mary's are coached by Mr. Kevin White and assisted by Mr. Mike Ryan. Their athletic director, Mr. Patrick Welsh. The Crusaders of Monsignor Scanlon, their head coach Mercedes Dukes, their assistant coach Naisha Irizarry, their athletic director Maxwell Cole. Mercedes Dukes, I remember her playing days. She was quite the student athlete on the basketball court. Left her mark for sure. Now she's on the sidelines. Coaching Monsignor Scanlon.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I ask that you please rise and remove your hats to the flag of the national purpose of the Catholic High School Athletic Association to promote the highest standard of fair play and sportsmanship. Keeping in mind the Catholic Christian beliefs of all our schools and promoting this belief with the behavior of our student athletes, coaches, and spectators, that is about criticism, we will adhere to the code of conduct as put forth by the bylaws of each sport. At this time, we ask the teams to please shake hands and wish our opponents good luck before today's contest. Good afternoon and welcome to Hofstra University for today's Girls Catholic High School Athletic Association AA State Championship.
Getting ready for the game introduction.
The Monsignor Scanlon Crusaders and the St. Mary's Devils.
The home team on the scoreboard today will be St. Mary's.
Here's the White. First,
Monsignor Scanlon.
The purple teams and the Monsignor Scanlon Crusaders. Number 11, Maria Stone.
Starting for Monsignor Scanlon.
Number 11,
Maiva Stone. Number 13, Angelina Tirado. Number 23, Rebecca Osu.
Number 24, Osu. And number five, Jada Lutter.
Number 24, Evan Harper, and number 5, Jada Leonard.
And now the starting lineup
for St. Mary's.
Number 24, Kayla Williams.
Number 24, Kayla Williams.
Number
20, Allison Ntombwe. Number 3, Tara Murray. Alyssa Blaylock. Officials have taken the court. We are waiting for the starting lineups to enter the jump ball circle at center court. St. Mary's will be representing the Diocese of Rockville Center, while Monsignor Scanlon will be representing Brooklyn, Queens, the Diocese of Brooklyn and Queens. In the circle for St. Mary's, Taryn Marbeau. For Monsignor Scanlon, number 24, Kayla Williams. And Monsignor Scanlon takes possession first. At the point, number 5, Jada Leonard. Alicia Blaylock with the pressure. A three-pointer by number 13, Angelina Toronto. Pressure by Monsignor Scanlon, three-quarter press. Blaylock goes in, rebound Barbeau. Murray with the perimeter shot. Rebound by Blaylock for two. St. Mary's in their 2-3 zone, applying a lot of pressure. Barbeau ties her up, but Mercedes Dukes calls a timeout. 30 seconds. Monsignor Scanlon will inbound from midcourt. Jada Leonard up top. Alyssa Blaylock. Tara Murray ties her up. We have a jump ball, St. Mary's. Two-two-one, full court pressure by Scanlon. Ball is thrown out of bounds by St. Mary's. Thank you. Rebound by Use Owusu. Foul goes to St. Mary's, first team foul. Ball goes into the post. She kicks it out. A give and go at the wing. Ball's stolen by St. Mary's. Alyssa Blaylock. High post is wide open for Monsignor Scanlon. The turnaround jumper is no good. And Barbeau leads the break. Into the game for St. Mary's, number four, Taylor Barbeau. And number 12 for Monsignor Scanlon, Nicole Bescomi. Ball is passed into the post, but she is quickly triple teamed. That's a jump ball. Scanlon remains in possession under their own basket. Leonard's shot is short. Blaylock's pass is too strong. And Leonard goes to the basket and is fouled by Blaylock. Leonard going to the line, shooting two. We have a great crowd here for this AA championship, and Leonard puts one in. We are tied at four. Second is rims out. Barbeau leading the break, kicks it to the corner. Scanlon with the rebound. Ball is tipped by Barbeau. Staying here with 24 on the shot clock. St. Mary's in that 2-3 zone. Deflected by the defense, but Scanlon picks it up. Leonard picks up a loose ball and is fouled. Allison Utabwe picks up her first, team's fourth. Leonard on the line, shooting two. Hits the first. And the second. Barbeau's pass is deflected. Scanlon comes up with it. Leonard on the break. Blaylock is there to slow her up. Great ball handling by Leonard to get the shot off. Scanlon doing a great job on the boards. Tipped out of bounds by Monsignor Scanlon. What an effort by Monsignor Scanlon's number 23, Rebecca Ose Owusu. No look pass by Blaylock. into Barbeau. Blaylock's shot is off the mark. Scantlin has possession for a brief period of time, but St. Mary's gets it back. Goes inside again. Blaylock with the shot. Rebound Barbeau. And that basket is good by Taylor Barbeau. Ball goes into the post, off the rebound. Heaven Harper puts it back in. Tara Murray to the basket for two. We are tied at eight. 2:45 remaining in the first quarter. We have a good matchup this afternoon in this final championship game of the day, the double A. Short. Rebound, Taryn Barbeau. But she is fouled by Monsignor Scanlon, number 12, Nicole Ben-Cosme. Into the game, number 24, Kayla Williams for St. Mary's. Barbeau to Murray for three. To Harper, and number 12, Ben Skozma, he deflects the ball out of bounds. Number four into the game, Diamond Field for Scanlon. Scanlon in a 2-3 zone. And Taryn Barbeau for three.
Taryn Barbeau.
Rebound, Barbeau, one-handed pass to her sister. Locks her under the basket for the reverse for two. By Taylor Barbeau, and a timeout is called. 16-8, timeout, Monsignor Scanlon. Taylor did a great job, Taryn did a good job looking up court, getting the ball to her sister Taylor, who locks the defense under the basket with that reverse layup. We have a lot of St. Mary's fans in the house at Hofstra today. The cheering squad behind the basket of Monsignor Scanlon is quite plentiful this afternoon. Oh, here we go. Some signs in the house and some happy fans. A lot of determination on that St. Mary's court today in that sideline. These girls are playing with a purpose right now. Let's see what Monsignor Scanlon can do. Travel called on number 12, Ben Skozmi. Avalon St. Mary's, Scanlon possession. We are under a minute in the first quarter, 16-8. See if Scanlon can cut the gap. Leonard spots up, and she hits a long-range three. 16-11. Full court pressure by Scanlon. Alyssa Blaylock handling the pressure is fouled by Leonard. Her first, team second. Taylor Blaylock handling the point. Goes to feed the post. It's deflected. Ase Owusu with the steal. Inside to Harper for two. And just like that, it's 16-13. Scanlon is knocking on the door. Collision. Barbeau with the putback, 18-13. And that will do it for the first quarter of play. St. Mary's leads Monsignor Scanlon, 18-13. A lot of fan support here for both teams. Great energy in the Mac Center. Both of these teams coming off the AA championships in their respective dioceses. St. Mary's will start the second quarter in possession. Monsignor Scanlon coming out in their 2-3 zone. A 1-3-1 set by St. Mary's. Blaylock's shot is short. She thought it was deflected. Murray plays great defense on Scanlon. Barbeau with the feed inside. Kayla Williams is blocked after multiple rebounds, but St. Mary's will remain in possession with 27 seconds left on the shot clock. Number 11 into the game, Neve Stone for Monsignor Scanlon. Kayla Williams with the rebound and the putback. She's playing big inside today, ladies and gentlemen. Great effort on the boards. That foul on number 23, that Ose Owusu. That's her first. Rebound by Monsignor Scanlon. They push the ball up. Ball goes inside. High, low. Nice play by Monsignor Scanlon from Leonard to Harper. Travel by Blaylock. Head-to-head competition today between the Gales and the Crusaders. Rebound by Barbeau to Murray. Murray spots up, and she is short. Rebound Blaylock. She settles the offense. Kayla Williams, short jumper. Ball is knocked out of bounds by Blaylock. Montina Scanlon will remain in possession. Shot is jammed up. Alyssa Blaylock in transition for two. St. Mary's matching up, putting some full court pressure. Looks like a 2-2-1. Listen to the fans. They are dialed in today. Leonard off the screen, her shot rims off the front. Pass ahead to Barbeau, but from Blaylock is too strong. Great look by Blaylock. 5:30 remaining in the second. Stone to Harper for two. Monsignor Scanlon closes in, 22-17. Rebound, Scanlon. Full court pressure. Leonard has no problem bringing the ball out. Nice spin move, but the foot comes down. And that's a travel on number 23, Rebecca Osei-Owusu. We see Scanlon's 2-2-1, and we have an official's timeout. Coming into the game for Monsignor Scanlon, number 25, Gabrielle Wilson, and Harper takes a break at 4:52 in the second. Barbeau penetrates the gap. Short jumper for two, 24-17. Both coaches pacing the sidelines, getting their steps in today. Lennon short is off. Great job getting to the bucket. Blaylock passes ahead to Murray. Murray to Barbeau. Barbeau clears the defense, but her shot is short. Rebound by Scanlon Stone. She goes coast to coast, and Murray tips it out of bounds. 23 seconds on the shot, and Harper returns into the game. Quick break for Harper. 4:04 remaining in the second. Nice catch by Osei-Owusu without the travel. Number 13, Angelina Tirado, is fouled. Tirado on the line shooting two. St. Mary's fans are getting loud. Toronto misses her first. unaffected by the distractions on her second. One of two. Murray penetrates baseline. She goes for the reverse, but it's too high. Ball goes out to Blaylock. And it's jammed up between the rim and the backboard for a jump ball. Scanlon will take possession. I think I might have to go down and jump and knock that ball out. All right. Help of the official. Gameplay will continue. Ball goes over the top to Ase Owusu. That shot is partially blocked. Leonard goes hard to the basket, rolls out. Blaylock in transition. Blaylock. Go to Murray for three. Great ball movement by St. Mary's. And St. Mary's calls a timeout, leading 27-18. St. Mary's coach Kevin White calling that quick timeout after that three, providing his team with their next strategy. Mercedes Duke speaking to our point guard, Jada Leonard. Leonard's taking some great shots that just haven't fallen. These rims tend to be tight here at the Mac Center. Wow. Great look inside, deflected off the hands of Monsignor Scanlon, Angelina Tirado. Number 12, Miss Cosby back in the game, replacing Ose Owusu. Scanlon still in that 2-3 zone. Penetration by Barbeau, and the dish to Williams for two. St. Mary's with an 11-point lead. Monsignor Scanlon needs to strike offensively. That look inside by Leonard is picked up by Barbeau. Ahead to Barbeau for two. Taylor Barbeau puts it in. 31-18. Weak side rebound by Nicole Vescosme with the putback. Tie up by the defense. Murray launches a long shot. And a jump ball ensues. St. Mary's has possession. Monsignor Scanlon, Crusader, making their way up the stands. St. Mary's in a 1-4 flat inbound. Williams, great position. The shot is short. Rebound Harper, putback is off. Ball falls into Leonard's hands. She tries to get one off, gets a rebound. And St. Mary's gets possession, but Laylock is fouled by Leonard. Her second, team second. Scanlon looking to use their press to slow down the offense. And they force a turnover by Blaylock. Miss Gozmi handling the ball at the point. Shot in the corner is short. Rebound Blaylock up to Murray. St. Mary's very patient right now. Skip to Murray. And Williams is called for 3 seconds. St. Mary's in a 2-2-1. Ball's out of bounds, but last touch by St. Mary's. 25.1 seconds left in the second quarter of play. St. Mary's up 11 on Monsignor Scanlon. Great shot selection. The ball will just not drop. Open it ahead. Barbeau passes it to Blaylock. And Murray is called for a travel. Into the game for Scanlon, Arielle Lucas, number 22. Barbeau fires a long shot from midcourt. And the second quarter, St. Mary's out in front, 31-20. We will take a short break and return to start the second half, with St. Mary's leading 31-20 over Scanlon. Thank you. All right, everybody, get your seatbelts on for the second half of this AA championship girls basketball game. St. Mary's with an 11-point lead over Monsignor Scanlon. Laying it on the line in the second half. All you got. Whether you're a Crusader or a Gale, this is it. The last 16 minutes of high school basketball for this year. To thank Hofstra University for hosting our championship basketball today. Ryan Watson and his staff always doing an amazing job. All the supervisors and ticket takers, and let's not forget our cameraman, Jamie. Doing an outstanding job with this trifecta of basketball action. Scanlon will inbound the ball to start the second half. Leonard in command. St. Mary's coming out, man to man. Blaylock tries to front Harper and forces an off-balance shot. Barbeau in transition. Ball gets reversed to Murray on the weak side. She drives. Harper rotates, and it's Scanlon ball up and ahead. Leonard keeps it in bounds. And the ball is tipped away by Taryn Barbeau. Nice feed by Leonard, who also gets a rebound. She's stripped by Blaylock. Blaylock loses her handle. Leonard recovers. And that will result in a score for Angelina Toronto. Scanlon strikes first in the second half with a double team. Ball is thrown away, and Murray keeps it in bounds. St. Mary's looking to settle right now. Long shot. Rebound by Williams, and Harper grabs it. Barbeau with the rebound. She looks ahead to Alyssa Blaylock, who scores 33-22. And Kevin White from St. Mary's calls a timeout. 33-22, 6:09 remaining in the third. Scanlon basketball coming in. A little confusion up top, but Monsignor Scanlon secures it. Shot is off the mark, and Barbeau in transition. Kicks it to Murray, who saves it. three to put St. Mary's up by 14. Harper with a nice footwork. The basketball is short. Karen Barbeau goes hard to the basket, deflected by Taylor Barbeau. And Taryn Barbeau opening the corner for three. Taryn Barbeau is dialed in to start off the second half. Mercedes Dukes has seen enough. It is a timeout, Monsignor Scanlon. The Crusader is hyping up the fans on the Scanlon side. Oh, and that only ignites the fans here supporting the gals. It's great to see this atmosphere for girls' basketball championships. 4:51 remaining in the third. St. Mary's in a 2-2-1 press. Let's see what Scanlon has on the slate to break it. Over the top to Leonard. That was easy. Coast to coast, it's off. Barbeau leading the break, passes it to Taylor Barbeau in the corner. Murray drives and dishes it to Barbeau. The shot is off, rebound, Scanlon. Intercepted by Blaylock. Barbeau with a two. Karen Barbeau dialed in and has a hot hand right now. Scanlon will be called for a travel. 41-22. St. Mary's will inbound. Ball is tied up by Leonard, but Williams gets it and tries to get it off before the shot clock violation. Scanlon will take the ball inbounds. Taylor Barbeau tips it away for the rebound. Brings it up top. Taryn Barbeau looks for the high-low pass. but Williams is not available. Looks inside and hits Toronto for two. Scanlon in a run and jump pressure. They're picking it up. Harper with the rebound. The ball goes back to the quarterback, Leonard. Harper spots up for two. Scanlon slowly cutting into this lead that was almost 20 points. Cut down to 15. That foul on Diamond Fields, Monsignor Scanlon, number four. Ase Owusu back in the game for Scanlon. Nice ball movement. Barbeau to Blaylock to Murray for three. St. Mary's brought their perimeter game today. Tip from Taylor to Taryn Barbeau. Less than a minute remaining in the third. Inside to Williams. Gets her own rebound. Gets another rebound. And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Scanlon. What an effort by St. Mary's number 24, Kayla Williams. Into the game for Scanlon, number 12, Nicole Viscosmi. Muriel inbound for St. Mary's. Foul on St. Mary's number three, Tara Murray. Going to the line, shooting two, number 12, Nicole Ben-Cosmi. Housing misses both. St. Mary's takes possession. Officials timeout. Number 22, Arielle Lucas, is taken out of the game. Was attended to by the trainer. 31.3 seconds on the inbound. Taryn Barbeau running the point. Scanlon in a man-to-man defense. Tara Murray from up top with the long shot. And Taylor Barbeau with the rebound. Bounces it into Williams, who gets fouled with 2.4 remaining on the clock in the third. Third foul on Jada Leonard. Into the game, The official is going to allow the subs to come into the game. Into the game for St. Mary's, number 12, Taylor Clayton, replacing Alyssa Layla. Williams misses the first. She is replaced by number 20, Allison Natambwe. The ball is tipped by Barbeau, Kayla Barbeau, and the clock expires at the end of three quarters of play. St. Mary's leads 45-26. Immediately following the conclusion of this game will be our awards ceremony that will take place at midcourt. Oh, we have some happy St. Mary's fans down there. We still have 8 minutes of play remaining. We'll be back in a few seconds. St. Mary's is 8 minutes away. Can they hold off Scanlon? It's all or nothing right now. St. Mary's will start in possession to kick off the fourth quarter. Williams gets the ball in the inbound. She handles it. That was close. Laylock setting up the offense. Scanlon playing man to man. Into Williams, who takes it to the bucket for two. Scanlon doing a great job on the boards. And the bucket is good by number 23, Ose Owusu. Passed head to Murray, forcing the Scanlon defense to hustle back in transition. Taylor Barbeau left wide open, and she is fouled by Monsignor Scanlon, number 23. Ose Owusu. Taylor Barbeau will shoot two. First one is good. Ball goes into the post. She splits the defense for two. That basket is good for number 23, Rebecca Ose Owusu. Turning it on. Taryn Barbeau splits the defense and is fouled. Four out, one in. Ball goes to Williams. Barbeau, double teamed by the Barbeaus, forces a turnover. Blaylock leading the transition. Blaylock spots up, doesn't go. Scanlon pushes the ball ahead, almost stolen by. Oh, and Leonard gets her own rebound and put back. Getting some scrappy matchups right now. 5:50 remaining, 49-32. Coach White calling out his offense. Barbeau settling things down. Two bigs high. Wilson sets the screen, but Murray's shot is blocked. And she is fouled. She will be going to the line, shooting three. This is not easy. Murray hits the second. Misses the third. She goes 1 for 3. Leonard to the basket for two. We have a 16-point lead for St. Mary's. We got the cheerleaders and the Crusader from Monsignor Scanlon picking it up, as well as the student section for St. Mary's. And we have Alyssa Blaylock fouled, going to the free throw line, shooting two. Fourth team foul for Scanlon. The first rims out. Taryn Barbeau picks her pocket, keeps the ball alive, gets it to Murray. And the ball's being moved around the perimeter. Barbeau for two. 52-34. Leonard quickly pushes it up court. And Scomi goes to the basket and is fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Back into the game for Scanlon, number 22, Arielle Lucas. The first is good for Lucas. Full court pressure by Monsignor Scanlon, giving it all they've got, the last 4:17 in the fourth. Almost a travel violation. Layla! The senior, the sole senior on the St. Mary's team goes to the basket, sending a message. Block out by Barbeau, but nobody gets Ben Scome. Barbeau's shot is short, but Williams with the rebound and a jump ball. Scanlon will get possession with 3:28 remaining in the fourth. Skousny handling the ball for Scanlon, passes it inside to Osei Asue. Kevin White calls a timeout for St. Mary's. Blaylock hits one. One remaining. This is the second. A lot of pressure by Scanlon. Leonard comes up with it, dishes it to Stone. She's short. Barbeau to Barbeau to Murray. And they settle the offense with 2:28 remaining. Taryn Barbeau with the bucket. 2 minutes remaining. pass from Stone to Harper for two. 57-40. The Crusaders are down by 17. Then Cosme with a foul. Blaylock going to the line to shoot two. Remaining. Ball is stolen by Barbeau. Tarrant settles the offense, and Coach Kevin White calls a timeout with 1:30 remaining. St. Mary's leading 58-40. Championships have not been held for the past 2 years, 20 and 21. We're on a hiatus. They return this year. St. Mary's has been waiting for this opportunity. 1 senior on the St. Mary's squad, number 1. Alicia Blaylock. Great effort by Blaylock and Bess Cosme. Cosme picks up the foul. Into the game for Monsignor Scanlon, number 2, Samaya Cano. Cuts the gap, 59-42. We are under a minute. St. Mary's is 45 seconds away from bringing this championship home. Rebound, Barbeau. They are moving the ball. Another St. Mary's timeout with 43.4 seconds remaining, 22 seconds on the shot clock. Most St. Mary's fans are happy about what they saw on the court today. All of our fans today fighting for TV time. Everyone a fan. Nice play in the inbounds to Blaylock. Monsignor Scanlon comes up with the tip. They keep it inbounds. Seconds. Senior Alyssa Blaylock comes out of the game after a magnificent career at St. Mary's High School. She's replaced by number 4, Taylor Blaylock. Taylor Barbeau. Congratulations to both Monsignor Scanlon and St. Mary's on an incredible year. And we look forward to seeing these teams next year in the 22-23 season. At this time, direct your attention to midcourt, where the award ceremony will take place. Awards will be distributed by our Catholic High School Athletic Association President, Denise Hillig, and assisted by the Nassau-Suffolk Catholic High School Girls Athletic Association President, Lorraine Bukalis, and the St. Mary's Athletic Director, Pat Welsh.
Thank you.